Many organisations like to have a single number that they have their clients and business partners ring in on, and then an individual, a person in a receptionist style of role, passes on those phone calls to other people. And in this video, we're going to show you how to do that for a smaller office.
That's right.
What do we need to do to get started?
Well, first of all, we need to understand a couple of concepts. Now, there are features within Tippit called multi-line and multiple call appearance.
Yep.
Now, what they refer to is multi-line means the number of keys on your handset that have the primary line appearing.
Right.
And multiple call appearance means the number of lines on each of those keys.
Yep.
So when you get a default handset for a user set up from scratch, hasn't been changed, they will have a multi-line one, meaning one key, and a call appearance of two, meaning it can take an active call and then have another one calling in or being on hold at the same time.
Sure. Got
okay.
It. All right.
So for this receptionist console, what we're going to do is we're going to use, say, multi-line six is going to be the example we show. So
okay.
Six keys.
Yep.
But we're going to leave the call appearances too. And the reason we do that is that Telstra recommends that rather than overloading the keys with too many primary lines, you go with a modest number of lines on those keys. So we're going to go with a call appearance of two. So you can see at the moment our console, if we look at the phone itself, our console has the key with the primary line on it.
Yep.
And then
that
we have
numbers the 62328301 number. Yeah.
Okay, so that's the company
that's
number
the company
effectively.
Number, yes.
And then we have a virtual line somewhere to park calls if we need to. And then we have a heap of BLFs, so speed dials effectively, so that the receptionist, in this case Lu Chan, can forward calls quickly to the person who is asked for by the caller.
And all of those extension numbers are within the number range of this group.
That's right.
Yeah.
So what we're going to do first is we're going to create the additional multi-lines.
Okay, good. All right.
So in this case, in the Tippit administration portal, we're going to the user, in this case, Lu Chen, bringing up Lu Chen's profile, and then we use custom tags to control the number of multi-line keys. So in this case, we add a tag, and the tag names are PLK-X, where X equals the key number of concern. So in this case, we are turning it on key by key. So we're going to use a tag name of PLK. In this case, you can see I've done it before because PLK2 is appearing.
Yep.
So we take that one and we simply turn the tag value to one to indicate
it's on.
Yep.
And again, another reminder that tags are very, very specific in how you have to write them down. So hyphen rather than underscore in this case. And so through the magic of video, we've entered all those details for the multi-line keys. And Chris, what are you going to do now?
Okay, because they go in as custom tags, I'm going to go to the files tab. I'm going to rebuild the files for the phone and then reset the phone. And then we'll see in a moment the phone will begin its reset function. There it is. You can see the LED flashing for the first key. Okay, you can see how all of the multi-lines have appeared up to line key six, and then we'll have the BLFs appear shortly after. Now, because we now have all of these additional multi-lines involved, you can see that the BLFs are spilling over onto the cam.
Well, good work, Chris. Let's test it, make sure it's working.
All right, so we're going to... Oh, we have a call already. Let's answer it. And we will put it on hold. So that's our first call
okay,
to Lu Chan at reception.
Yep.
How about you call?
I might ring somebody. I'm going to ring Lu and say, how are you going?
And we'll answer you and put you on hold. I'll call.
Okay.
So at the moment, you can see that both calls appeared on the first key.
Yes.
So if I call, it's now moved to the second key.
Because there's only two lines on each of these multi-lines.
Correct.
Yep.
Now, just at this point, it's worth highlighting that you don't necessarily know which key it's going to turn up on. So sometimes you can have a call come in a little later and it might come on a different key.
Right.
Doesn't matter.
Okay.
The receptionist will become used to dealing with that. So we'll put one more call in there. And this is using the WebEx client that I have running as well, and we'll put that one on hold as well. Now what we're going to do is we're going to forward one of the calls in this case Sam colleague, and Sam has
the
phone.
Sam's phone.
All right,
great.
So let's forward Charlie. So we've got Charlie's already active. You can see on the screen that Charlie's listed there
and he's been on hold for 27 seconds, so let's move him quickly.
All right, so we'll resume. transfer to Sam.
And Sam is ringing. I'll answer it. Thank you, Lou. I guess I've got a call coming in.
We better get rid of the echo. Now, at this stage, the receptionist talks to Sam, says, I've got a call for you. Sam says, okay, I can take it. So we do the transfer. And
Thank you
now
much.
Have the call.
So there it is, a receptionist console on a phone with Tippett.